somewhere. And it's going to be a very tough match for Great Britain today, and really a match for Italy to try and assert their authority a little bit. They've started strongly, as I said, against Dominican Republic and Japan, but another win today would leave them in a very strong position in the pool. There are some Italians. We knew we'd find some somewhere. And they're up, about to tear their team on. They're rather outnumbered up there, aren't they? Two referees today, Zorica Bjelic and Deni Kaspidis Lassi. One Serbian, and the gentleman on the right you can see there from the Dominican Republic. And they're going to be keeping track of what's going on in this match today. Both experienced referees, as you'd imagine. And then in a moment we will have the teams called onto the court, and we'll see which six players are going to be starting for either side as well. There you can see Simona Gioli. She's the woman standing up on the left-hand side there. She's really the danger player, as I said. 34 points so far in this London 2012 Olympic Games. Julia Rondon onto the court, as well as Jenny Baratza. Simona Gioli enters the court. And there you can see the starting lineup then. So there are the seven players that will begin this match for Italy. Eleonora Lobianco, the captain, not starting. And Great Britain get a huge cheer as Lucy Wicks comes out onto the court. 30-year-old from Swindon. Made five spikes in their first two games, so she's certainly one to watch out for at the net. Rachel Laybourne, also 30 years old, comes from Sheffield, plays her volleyball in Poland for Sielce Wolomilswicz. Maria Bertelli in white, as she is the libero. And Lynn Beattie, the captain. Really a lot of Britain's hopes today are going to be on her shoulders. And I think the middle blockers are going to be very important today. The likes of Grace Carter and Kira Michelle have really got to try and stop the threat, mainly of that woman, Simona Gioli. Very prolific, very experienced, 34 years of age. Born in Rapallo in Italy. And she is going to be, I think, the major threat for Great Britain. Janine Sandel. She's going to serve. And Great Britain about to get this match against Italy underway. Zorica Bjelic is happy, and Great Britain versus Italy begins. Not a great start for the British. Janine Sandel serving the ball out of play. And Jenny Baratza now will take the serve for Italy. One all. Chiara Michelle rising at the net. Well, it was a very good dig in there from Janine Sandel, but the spike went out of play. And now Lucia Bassetti will serve for the Italians, who now have a 2-1 lead in this opening set. Lynn Beattie picks up her first point of the game. One of many Great Britain will be hoping. Timing the jump to perfection, and Julia Rondi got her arms in the way, but could only deflect it behind. Lucy Wicks now to serve for Britain. Very good dig from Grace Carter. But finished off in style from Costa Grande. Born in Argentina was Costa Grande in Santa Fe, but she is Italian, and she's won a point for the Italians. And that's a good block. Antola Del Core getting in at the net. Italy go 4-2 up. Rachel Laybourne it was, rising for Great Britain. Now Costa Grande, after winning that point to make it 3-2, will serve. Maria Bertelli going down. Couldn't dig the ball out enough. 5-2 to Italy. They're starting this match very assertively. Little touch over the net from Rondon. And Bertelli was just moving backwards. Rachel Laybourne wins that point. Costa Grande couldn't quite keep it in before careering into the London 2012 hoardings. Three, five now. Lynn Beattie, the captain of Great Britain, to serve. Well, it was fantastic defensive work from Lynn Beattie, the number 10 for Great Britain. But she couldn't do enough to stop Italy winning the point. The amount of digs she got in there was phenomenal. Italy themselves doing some good digging. That was the quick reactions. And then Lucy Wicks, unable to keep it up at the last moment. Italy go into a 7-3 advantage now. Simona Gioli. Well, the timeout's been called. She was about to serve. But only 1 point so far for Gioli. Which is from a serve. Yet to see her prowess at the net, really. In these opening 10 points. Good team spirit in the British team. Wicks keeps it in. The spike was blocked, but it was only deflected over and out of play. And that's the first technical timeout of the match when one team reaches 8 points, and it's Italy who have reached it 8 points to three in this opening set. And they're looking.
If the shot isn't there, look for the hands of the blocker. Okay, side out here, yeah? And then we start to train and go after them, yeah? Nice time on this ball. Here we go. They're changing their serve, it's for everyone.
I think they're just encouraging Great Britain to calm down a little, take their time. Italy will be more than happy with how things are progressing so far. Even though we haven't seen many big scorers from them yet. 2 points so far for Antonella Decora, who is one of really a three-pronged attack. Gioli there, you can see Decora and Arrighetti, Italy's three most dangerous players. Great Britain winning the point. Good start for them after the technical timeout. Lucia Bassetti it was. Serve from Grace Carter. The slam is blocked. Chiara Michele it was at the net, going for the spike, but it was Rondon who got the block in. And Italy go 9-4 up now. Chiara Michele again, tallest player on the British team, proves her worth. That's her second point of the match. Rachel Laybourne now will serve, 9-5. And that was a good spike from Lucia Bassetti. Found the space well. Just to the right of Lynn Beattie. And now Del Corre will take the serve. 10-5 Italy. And the ball lands out of play. Rachel Laybourne trying to get a touch onto it. But it's 11-5 to Italy. No time wasted with the serve. Maybe a little bit more time should have been taken. It flies straight out of play over the far baseline. Italy perhaps trying to catch Great Britain off guard. Backfired a little bit. 6-11 now. Great Britain have the serve. With Janine Sandel. And it's a good block at the net from Chiara Michele. Deflecting it down as Baratza tried to finish off the spike. Much to the disappointment of Massimo Barbellini. Barbellini, I should say. And that will be the point to Italy. 12-7 now. Great Britain still in this set, though. Things are looking a bit precarious at 8-3. But Great Britain continue to pull themselves back in. It's now 12-8 to Italy. Positioning not quite right from Costa Grande there. Michelle. Oh, that was clever. Very, very clever from Lucia Bassetti. The British team expecting the spike. The powerful spike at least, and in the end it's a very cheeky little push to guide the ball into the British area. Lynn Beattie picks up a point. Neither side really getting a proper grip. It's one point at a time stuff for both teams. Italy extend an advantage and Britain pull it back. Now Lucy Wicks. Better serve than her first. Italy played themselves into a bit of trouble there, not really getting the chance for the spike. But they did that. And Costa Grande wins the point. Fourth point of the match won now for Costa Grande. All of them have been spikes. And after our bigging up of Simona Gioli, she's still only picking up the one point. And Great Britain win that one. 10-14, it was Gioli who brought the foul. Deep serve. Spike is well blocked. Italy keep the ball in play. And that spike wasn't blocked at all. Antonella Del Core, 31-year-old from Napoli, makes it 15-10 now to Italy. Serve goes straight out. 15-11. Grace Carter. Haven't seen too much of her in this match so far. A few decent digs, but she serves and Britain win the point. Janine Sandel was in there with the spike. Carter once again will serve. 12-15. Straight out though. Straight out. All that hard work undone. And as a result, we will have the second technical timeout. Italy moving on to 16 points. 4 points clear now of Great Britain. And fairly calm figure of Massimo Barbellini. And there's a young Italian fan who will be more than happy with how the Italians are progressing so far. Real medal candidates. After winning the World Cup last year, they might only be ranked fourth in the world, but you've got to say they're amongst the favourites to take gold. And you can see that the kind of performance that we've come to expect from the Italians. Very few unforced errors. I think that's probably one of the biggest differences we've seen so far. A good service ratio. Match back underway. And the spike has landed in. Lucia Bassetti it was who forced it downwards to the near side of the court. A few boos, I think, perhaps the British fans here at Earls Court disagree with that decision. It was a very close call, but Italy given the point. Wick sets it up, that's a brilliant dig. Brilliant dig from Paolo Croce. But there's the block. Chiara Michelle really performing strongly. Actually, I think it was Janine Sandel who got the final touch on that one. Unlucky there for Rachel Laybourn. Did a great job to get to it, but couldn't quite direct it in the right way. The spike coming in from Del Core. Laybourn did fantastically well to get down there, but the ball was spinning in the wrong direction for Wicks, who then wins the point for Britain at the net, 18-14. Touching the net. Jenny Bazzara. Janine Sandel serves. Oh, it's gone straight out. Didn't look particularly strong for the moment. It left her hand. And again, a service error for Britain. We've had many more of those than Italy have so far. Two Italians diving for it. Neither of them could keep it going. Barazza and Del Core it was. Britain bring it back to 15-19 now. Now we're seeing a few substitutions. Monica Di Gennaro, 25-year-old, plays for Scavalloni Pesaro. In Italy, she now takes to the court. Powerful spike, but a good block again from Laybourn. And that's been called in. Italy go 20-15 up. Very close there on the baseline, but the line judges were there. Lucia Bossetti. Drop short that serve. Britain do well to keep it in play. And then do well to block it as well. Grace Carter at the net. Just diverting it downwards. Carter has picked up 12 spikes so far in this tournament. And that's gone straight out again from the serve for Great Britain. Certainly something to work on, isn't it? And Italy 21, Great Britain 16. First to 25 points. There you can see the service errors. 4 for Britain, 2 for Italy. First to 25 wins the set. Hammered in by Grace Carter. Great Britain have got to keep their belief because Italy are looking strong and have that cushion towards that 25 points that they need. Mistake from Del Cora. Not often we see them, but the return just spirals off her left arm and out of play. Italy on the back foot a little here. The block from Laybourne at the net. In fact, the shot may have just been straight into the net. Carter and Laybourne taking the credits. And Italy, I think, have called the timeout. Because they are all of a sudden on the ropes here. There is Giola. Still only with the 1 point so far in this match. Very surprised we haven't seen more of her. Del Core at the moment, who's picked up 5 points, as has Costa Grande. The British fans starting to get into this match a little bit. It looked at the start as though it was going to be tough for Britain, but they've pulled it back now. It's their serve. 19-21, 19-22 make that. What we expected a little more from Simona Giroli. Jenny Baratza on. And the block goes out of play. 22-20. Grace Carter with the serve. Very dropping short. Italy just about keep it in play, but they can't keep that one in play. 22-21. The team ranked 69th in the world are giving the latest World Cup winners a real run for their money in this first set. Bossetti couldn't quite hook her left hand around it. And that's what it means to Audrey Cooper. They've pulled it level, 22 all. Determined fight back from Great Britain, and Italy are going to be wondering what exactly has happened to them in the second half of this first set. Rondon, it was at the net. And Italy call their second timeout. And Massimo Barbellini wants to know what's gone wrong in those last few minutes. British fans enjoying this one all of a sudden. And with a real chance of taking a set from Italy, which in itself will be quite an achievement. And here's Grace Carter. Italy move back into the lead, 23-22. Great Britain not quite able to sorted out amongst themselves. I think Chiara Michelle heard the call from Lucy Wicks just at the last moment before she could back out of it. Rondon takes the serve now for Italy. 2 points away from winning this first set. But so are Great Britain now. Spike from Bossetti just gets the deflection and lands in. Italy with set point. Britain have saved it, 24 all. Looks as though Jennifer Taylor is going to make her first appearance, coming on for Janine Sandel, who's done a solid job so far. So now it's going to be the first to get to two clear points who will take this opening set. Rachel Bragg coming on as well for Lucy Wicks, or maybe not quite yet. Bit of discussion. Substitution is not going to be made just yet, but Jennifer Taylor is on for Janine Sandel. 24 all. Great Britain to serve. 2 points clear. And they've won the set, and it's Italy who make the first step towards those 2 points. They've got a set point on their serve now, after another service error from Great Britain. Twenty-five all. Lynn Beattie in there again. The 26-year-old from Glasgow proving why she's one of the top British volleyball players around and why she deserves to be captain of the team. Her fifth point of the match so far. And it's 25 all. Oh, in came the spike from Costa Grande, and Britain couldn't deal with it. Audrey Cooper, the coach, almost had to deal with it on his near side. Italy with another set point. The slam from Costa Grande spears off Jennifer Taylor, and it's their third set point. And it's Italy's set. 27-25. She may have been fairly quiet in this opening set, but Simona Gioli is there when you need her. I think actually it was Rondon who got the final touch actually. On that far side, Gioli was in attendance. But yeah, it came down off Rondon. And Italy win the opening set. Massimo Barberini won't be particularly satisfied with how that set's gone, though. I imagine Italy shouldn't be pressed that hard by a Great Britain team making their Olympic debut. An Olympic team that's only been in existence since London won the right to host the Games. Here's a look at the statistics then. Great Britain not quite taking as much advantage of their spikes as Italy, but they've had a similar number of chances. Italy a lot stronger on the digs, and the service errors for Great Britain really letting them down. 5 service errors. And those 3 service errors difference, in theory, are enough to win the set when the scores are this close. So a very entertaining opening set here at Earls Court between Great Britain and Italy. It looked early on as though Italy were in a little bit of control, looking fairly comfortable in the opening points. In the very early stages, they were 9-4 up against Great Britain. And it looked as though it was going to be a tough ask, but Britain have hauled themselves back into, well, they had hauled themselves back into the set. But in the end, Italy was just too strong. And they've taken the opening set 27 points to 25. What can Great Britain do in this second set? That's going to be worth watching. Can they build on that momentum, or can Italy start to get their game together a little bit? So, the second set about to get underway. Best of five sets. So this will be at least the penultimate set. But we could possibly have another three afterwards. First to 25 is going to win the set. And as we saw there, 27-25 because of the necessity for two clear points. British fans enjoying cheering on their team, who delighted them with that 3-2 win over Algeria in their last pool match. So even though expectations were not particularly high against Italy, there's still that belief that something can come of it. The Italians really looking at this as a bit of a straightforward match coming into it, I'd imagine. No doubt they'll have said that no match is easy, but surely they feel they have enough strength to see off this British team. Key to that could be the second set, which Del Core gets underway. Italy take the lead immediately. Costa Grande was at the net. Two nil. Del Corre again to serve. Janine Sandel. It was who spiked it. The block was made by Jenny Baratza. He lands out of play. And Great Britain have a point on the board. 2-1. And, the referee, Zorica Bjelic, calls to stop that point after the collision between Janine Sandel and Grace Carter. I think it was Grace Carter who came off the worst in that little incident. And indeed, she's having to leave the field of play. David Goodchild, you could see the assistant coach just checking everything's all right. And this is the introduction now of Elizabeth Reed. She's come on to replace Carter. Plays volleyball for the University of Georgia in America. And Italy go 3-1 up. Lucia Bassetti it was. There's Jenny Baratza now serving for Italy. Good block, and it's 4-1. This is more like it from the Italians. More like it from Gioli as well. Although again, I'm not quite sure if that was her or her teammate who was just rising with her. Yep, it was Lucia Bassetti who won that point. And another point for Italy, 5-1 now. really starting to get into the flow of things. A little tap over the net. And on comes Savannah Leaf, youngest player for Great Britain, only 18 years of age, youngest player in this match. She comes straight in with a spike. Then a block that lands in play. And it's 6-1 to Italy. After the adrenaline and the highs of, it's going to be a timeout. It's been called by Audrey Cooper. Because Great Britain needs to do something to stop this slide a little bit. Yeah, Italy, on the other hand,
nice now, so
will be pretty pleased.
You're there with Lucy, but ends up being a little bit tight, yeah? She's holding with her right now, so that hole is actually open to Savannah in that seam, yeah? In the seam. Okay, we need to go and build again, ladies. Nice high pass, and make sure everyone's available for Lucy. Hey, don't forget the score. We just start to build. Here we go.
So, you can see the main desire is to get Lucy Wicks, who is the setter for Great Britain. Everyone's got to be available for her. Try and get the ball to Wicks. She'll set it up for someone to spike. There's the setup from Wicks. This time it's going to be the spike from Savannah Leaf, but it goes out. It goes in, I should say, sorry. And Great Britain get a point back. See why Leaf is in the team. Oh yeah, just touched the fingers, didn't it? Of Simona Gioli. Two 6 now. Serve goes straight out of play. Certainly something for Great Britain to work on. Rossetti. Italy unable to keep it in. And Britain finding a little bit momentum again. 3-7. Paolo Croce couldn't quite divert it back into play. And it'll be Leaf. Better serve this time from Savannah Leaf. Another lady to be playing volleyball for an American university, San Jose State University, for Savannah Leaf. And she's going to serve again and try and repeat the trick. Gioli came in with the spike, and it's 8-4 to Italy, and the first technical timeout is called. Great Britain have rallied a little bit after their first called timeout. But Italy looking strong. Barbellini looking a little more satisfied.
5 and 6 here, we're wasting zone 6 at the moment, yeah? So let's see if we can take that angle away. Okay, ladies, let's start to run our offense off this side out, yeah?
Little change of tactics then for Great Britain. Trying to attack the other side of the court. We'll see how well that transpires. Trying to get Lucy Wicks to have options the other side. We've seen her mainly setting up for Chiara Michelle. They're going to try and switch the play just a little bit. Italy, though, immediately take the point, 9-4. Costa Grande. Lucy Wicks goes for the spike herself. Didn't really have many options available. which I don't think will impress Audrey Cooper, but the shot itself will. Five, nine. Wick sets it up and it's a good spike from Elizabeth Reed. Over the back of the head, and that's a good shot actually from Reed. She spots the space in between the Italian players. And Great Britain now only 3 points behind Italy. Nothing to do to stop that one, though. Antonella Del Corre again, coming in strongly. Gone out. Savannah Leaf doing her best to keep the ball in play. Unable to do so, so Simona Gioli will serve now for Italy. Looks again trying to turn over the net. This time she gets the block in. 7-11. Similar blocks. Italy have had three more attempts at blocks. But Italy still lead this second set. Really strong Antonella Del Corre. Another point for her. As soon as it goes over to that far side of the court, you see her rising. You know that Great Britain are going to have a real problem trying to prevent the ball from hitting the floor. Rondon with the serve now. Sets it up, but it's a rather tame initially spike from Lynn Beattie, and then the block goes out of play. 13-7. Rondon will serve again. Beattie's spike is blocked, but it lands out of play. 13-8. And Beattie will now serve. Not a particularly strong spiking success rate so far for Beattie. Lucia Bassetti, on the other hand, and the Italians, very, very strong. Whenever it looks dangerous, it ends up being dangerous. Del Corre with the serve, and Maria Bertelli can't quite dig it out. 15-8. Italy pulling clear a little bit. Starting to unleash their power at the net and in the serve. And beautifully positioned from Lucia Bassetti. There's the technical timeout. You have to say, with Bassetti, it's not a... Her spikes aren't aimless slams of the ball by any stretch of the imagination. She spots the space and exploits it fantastically. And Italy will be much happier at this point. Pretty short team talk, in fact, from Massimo Barbellini.
Okay, guys, let's feel from here.
There you can hear the encouragement from the Glaswegian Lynn Beattie, the captain of Britain. Just forget about the score. Focus on each point. But the Italians will be pretty much focusing on the score, because they've got a 16-8 lead now. They had a similar lead in the first set. It's not time to discount Britain just yet, though. Del Corre with the serve. Good dig. Wick sets it up for Leaf. Blocks made. But the spike from Lynn Beattie wasn't good enough. And it's 17-8. On comes Rachel Bragg now to replace Rachel Laybourne. Bragg from Bromsgrove in Worcestershire. Can't stop those, can you? Jenny Baradza absolutely powering the spike over the net from the perfect set, really. And now off comes Elizabeth Reed, and on comes Grace Carter once more after that blow to the head in that, well, earlier on in this set, really. Rachel Bragg, her spike is blocked and then it comes back off her. And I think it was Jenny Baradza again getting the block in there. No, it was Costa Grande next to her. Thinking definitely along the lines of each set being broken down and not taking too much attention of the general score, because at the moment it's 19-8. Italy looking very strong. Great Britain seems to have just lost some of their shape that they had in the early stages, particularly towards the end of that second set. And Italy are getting stronger and stronger, finding the gaps on the court. Off comes Leaf and on comes Sandel. Another serve for Del Corre. Wick sets it. Straight into the match and straight into the fray for Janine Sandel. So fifth point of the match so far. Second highest scorer behind Lynn Beattie. For Great Britain at least. Del Corre and Bassetti have 9. Costa Grande has 10 points. For Italy, and that's another point for Italy. Straight off the back of the Great Britain serve, it's 21-9, and this set really looks like it's got away from Great Britain. The serve from Grace Carter landing out. Poor touch from Beattie. Get it back into play. It's a very good block. And the ball's landed out. Julia Rondon, who had to very, very quickly get some sharp reactions halfway through that rally. And then the spike landing well out in the end. Great Britain 10, Italy 22. Simona Gioli's spike. She's clipping the tops of the fingers. That perfect timing. 23-10. Britain keep it in play. And then win the point. Janine Sandel has looked very strong today for Great Britain. Whenever she's able to find the space, she looks very dangerous in front of the net. She'll now serve. But Great Britain still need a minor miracle to save this set. And that hasn't helped them. Set point now for Italy to take a 2-love lead. Costa Grande with her 11th point of the match so far. She'll serve for set point. Which sets it up nicely. And Chiara Michelle converts. Still Italy's set point though. And it will be for quite some time if Great Britain are able to save this. Oh, they're not. Two of them go for it. Neither of them get it. And Italy take a 2-love lead now here at Earls Court. They were run very, very close in the opening set by Great Britain, but it's been a different story in this second set. It's Michelle and Bragg both going for it. Both pull out, actually, I think. Either both pull out because they think they're going to hit each other, or both of them realise they're not going to make it. But 25-12 in that second set, a very strong performance from the Italians. Great Britain have had the chances with the spikes, just haven't been able to convert them. And Italy have been much better at getting the blocks in. And the digs as well. And again, two extra service errors for Great Britain. This is Italy's most commanding set win of the London 2012 Olympics so far. Previous to that, they beat the Dominican Republic 25-15 in the fourth set. But this is now their most comfortable set win of this 2012 tournament. And Great Britain's second worst set score so far as well. They only managed 10 against Russia in the second set there. But Italy are fine opposition. Very much in contention for medals here this year in London 2012. Reigning World Cup winners. In fact, double reigning World Cup winners, winning it in 2007 and 2011. Much more commanding performance in the second set for Italy. Great Britain just losing their shape a little bit. It seemed to be, especially in defence really, the attack seemed to be reasonably effective still. Lucy Wicks, the setter, doing a decent job of creating opportunities, as we saw from those statistics. Spikes wise, Great Britain have had the chances, but it's just defensively they have not been as strong and have not been as well organised as Italy. When we saw the amount of digs earlier, it was much stronger for Italy. So we head into the third set now. If Italy win it, it will decide the match. If Great Britain win it, we'll be going to a fourth set. And Italy could be winning all their matches 3-1 potentially. Can this become their first 3-love victory of the London 2012 Olympic Games? Great Britain will be hoping not. In front of their home crowd, they'll at least want to get one set on the board, but was that opening set their best chance to do so? Third set gets underway. Janine Sandel will serve for Great Britain at Earls Court. Italy continue where they left off. Great Britain continue where they left off, with a bit too much space in between their two rows. Jenny Baratza now to serve. We've hardly seen much of Chiara Michele in that second set. Very, very strong in set one. You can see six out of eight spikes for her overall. So when she gets the chance, she manages to convert them. And the serve lands in. Italy thought it was out. Three aces all now. Good block. Italy still keep the ball in play. Oh, lack of communication there from Great Britain. Just when it looked like they created the opportunity, it was a good layup from Lucy Wicks. And then it was Janine Sandel coming into the back of Lynn Beattie. And it's another point. This time Lynn Beattie is there at the far side of the court to just touch it over. And all of a sudden, Great Britain are leading this third set, 3-2. Wicks will take the serve. And Italy bring it back to 3-all. Simona Gioli getting the spike. And the block not quite working out for Lynn Beattie. Costa Grande. Wick sets it up. Leaf comes in with the spike. It's very well blocked by Maria Bertelli, the libero for Great Britain. Another good block. It was only going to be a matter of time before a powerful Italian spike landed. Britain did well to try and defend, but Italy now back into the lead, 4-3. Italy kept that in play. It looks like they have. The British fans here jumping to a bit of an early conclusion. Play continues. Britain win the point nevertheless. Beattie getting the block in. And look at this. Fantastic dig. Paolo Croce has done well when she's been called upon, but look how many more digs Italy have pulled out of the bag. That's where the points have been lost really for England, not so much in offence, but in defence. There's a dig. And the point goes to Italy. 5-4. Piccinini. Gioli with the serve. Sandel's spike is kept out. And Sandel then blocks the spike herself, but it lands out of bounds. Italy now with a 2-point advantage in this third set. Again, it was Francesca Piccinini who took the spike. Wick sets it up very nicely for Leaf. Five, six. Exploited the space well there. Savannah Leaf. And now Grace Carter will serve. Block was made from Leaf, but it came down on her own side. Piccinini's looked strong since she's come on. Picking up 3 points in her brief time on the court. That slam down from Savannah Leaf. Finds the gap perfectly. Leaf with the serve. Blocks May, but it lands out. Italy again into a 2-point advantage, and that brings them the first technical timeout of this third set. Much better, stronger performance, though, for Great Britain in this third set. Much tighter defensively. As a result, it's just making it a little bit more difficult.
Slide on this aerial. You two must be available for Lucy on that flight ball, yeah? Okay, because that gap is now opening up, yeah? Really super play, guys, so let's build again. Don't change anything, yeah? Continue to train and be aggressive from the service line. Here we go.
Similar team talk every time, really, from Audrey Cooper. Much happier, though, with how her team are playing now. Super play, as she described it. Very British description. The Italians, I think, will be fairly satisfied with how things are working out for them. They've been very clinical with their spikes. Especially Piccinini since she's come on. She's going to serve. Wicks lays it up, the block's in. And the point goes to Italy. Piccinini to serve again. Wicks lays it up this time for Sandel. The block comes in. Sandel will have another go. Oh, and they can't quite keep the ball in play. Chiara Michelle dropping to the ground to try and dig that one out. But Barazza, it was, who got the block. ...11-6 now to Italy. Since that technical timeout, they've started to take control of the game a little bit more. Piccinini, despite a strong performance since she's come on. Well, I thought she was being substituted, but actually it's just been a timeout. Great Britain call it, because Audrey Cooper, a bit disappointed with how things have gone since the last time out. Piccinini then will continue to stay on the pitch and will take her serve. British fans hopeful that their team can pull something off here, which would be quite remarkable. Lynn Beatty, though, with a spike that just lands in. Oh, that was a close one, wasn't it? Good call, though, from the line judges. 7-11. Janine Sandell to serve. Piccinini not quite able to keep that one going. The block from Chiara Michelle. Oh, they got the initial touch. If anything, the touch from Chiara Michelle took the pace off the ball, which made it more difficult to get to. 12-8 now to Italy. Serve from Baratza. Great Britain struggles to get it back into play. 13-8 now for Italy. Beatty not quite able to dig it out off the ground. I think she'll be disappointed with that one. Misjudged the flight of the ball there. Beatty plays her volleyball in Spain for Las Palmas de Gran Canaria. Lucy Wicks plays her volleyball in Germany for Almenia Aachen, and she has won the point to bring it back to 9-14. Just diverting it away from Consta Grande. Michelle with the serve, it was long. Italy 1 point away from the second technical timeout of this third set. And there it is. 16-9. Lucia Bassetti. Wins the point to take it to 16-9. Very impressive so far today, Lucia Bassetti. She's picked up 11 points for Italy. Costa Grande's picked up 12, including 10 spikes. Baratza as well has been quietly going about their business, picking up 2 aces. 4 spikes and a block to give her 7 points overall.
Let's give us the opportunity to play it, yeah? Okay, from here.
We don't want to stop playing yet. Okay, play to the end. Let's do it. Come on.
To defense. And good. Okay, this sound on then.
Team GB, as they're known, getting a great deal of support here in Earls Court, as you'd imagine. But they know that they are up against one of the best volleyball teams in the world. And if we don't see Italy in the battle for one of the medal positions, then I think the Italians will be very disappointed indeed. Beatty comes in and wins the point. 16-10. It's not over by any stretch of the imagination. We've seen the British determination in the first set. Waned a little in the second set. Couldn't quite get themselves together. But this has by no means been a poor performance in set three. Poor serve, though. And Costa Grande will now try and show Great Britain how it's done after Lucy Wicks served it long. Wicks sets it up for Beattie, but the block is made by Piccinini. Her first block of the game, her fourth point of the game, and timeout has been called.
Right, ladies, yeah. This is where we need to trade. We can't afford to let them get any more points here because we need to stick with them. Yeah, that's our goal now. We trade, we go back to service line aggression. We trade, we trade, we trade. We keep continuing to take points. Let's not give them anything here right now. They're not really having to work for much. Let's make them work hard. Yeah, here we go.
So, timeout comes to an end after that. Talking to from Audrey Cooper, saying they just need to take every point they can off Italy, and they just keep that ball in play. Leaf with the spike, it's dug out. Piccinini comes in. Great Britain keep the ball in play. Can't keep that one in play though. Simona Gioli on the far side of the court. Piccinini again in there where it matters at the net. Very experienced player, Francesca Piccinini. 33 years old from Pietrasanta in Italy. Plays for Foppa Pedretti BG. She only picked up 2 points in Italy's opening two matches. Hasn't really featured, but has really been a strong performance from her today. Great Britain get a point back, 20-11. But I think Piccinini might be in the running for a more regular place with performances like this. Now we've got Jennifer Taylor coming on to replace Lynn Beattie, the captain, who's taking a little breather as we surely, possibly, approach the end of this third set. Towards the lower ends of the match now, if Italy can keep up this kind of form. Piccinini digs it. Set up for Leaf. 21-11. Italy 4 points away from victory now. Gioli will serve. Just hits the net and stays on the British side. Perfect set, but a very good block from Sandel. 21-12. Sandel coming straight off after winning that point to be replaced by Rachel Bragg. Piccinini's in there again. Very impressed with that. Very, very dangerous at the net. There you can see Italy have really taken advantage of the spikes. Only two more spikes, but many more converted. I think Leaf hit the net there. And as a result, Italy are 23-12 up. Looks as though Audrey Cooper is staring at defeat for the British women's volleyball team. Powerful spike from Jenny Baratza. Apologies, it was Caterina Bossetti. Just getting away from Wicks. And it's match point to Italy. The match is won with the block. Bossetti it was, who was in there. Only scored 2 points in this match. But they were the two most important ones. And the Italian crowd absolutely delighted. The players shake hands with one another. Great Britain doing a good job to stay with Italy, especially in that opening set, which was really somewhat of a surprise. 27-25, pushing Italy all the way. Perhaps the second two sets went more the way one would have anticipated looking at them coming into this match. Great Britain ranked 69th in the world. Italy ranked 4th. There you can see it's the digs again. Italy very, very strong. They're getting the digs out and back into play, crucially. Great Britain make the digs, but they often head off wide. So victory for Italy gives them 3 out of 3. In the pool stage of this preliminary round of the 2012 London Olympic Games women's handball. It was an entertaining match. There you can see exactly the same amount of spikes, but Italy converting 15 more. Digs as well, it's a similar story, similar amount, but exactly double the amount of digs were made by Italy. Service errors 9-2, only 1 hour and 18 minutes. This means Italy a second in the group. Behind Russia on goal difference, or on point difference, I should say. Japan third, Britain fourth. Not a disastrous performance at all from them in their opening debut in women's volleyball here at the London 2012 Olympic Games. Dominican Republic not picking up a win, finishing in sixth, with Algeria in fifth place. So Italy move on now to really set their sights on a medal. Very strong performances we've seen from them. This is their first match where they haven't conceded a set. Very close to conceding that first set, to be fair. They need to work on getting out of the blocks just a little quicker, perhaps. But once they got themselves sorted, they were very, very difficult to play against. And I think the strong point for Italy is that they've got so many players capable of spiking points. That match we had Costa Grande picked up 12 points. Gioli picked up 10. Bossetti picked up 11. 6 for Piccinini, and she was only on the court for the second half, really. Baratza picked up 8 as well. Great Britain were relying mainly on Beatty and Chiara Michelle. And as a result, so many strong players in the Italian side that they don't have to rely on one in particular. Even Gioli didn't perform quite as strongly today, but picked up 10 points. So an entertaining match here at Earls Court. Italy have won it by 3 sets to love.